Paradox Live. I am Kuti from Say Hey to Art, and I will be your host for the evening. This lockdown period has been really strange, but there is one unique thing that this lockdown has done for all of us. Like for me, I'm always being behind the scenes. Today I'm very well. I think I'm much more channel and here today. So that's what the lockdown has done for me personally. So let me just introduce you to the concept of paradox. So what is paradox all about? So the paradox is a challenge. It's about the challenge of being, you know, confined to your four walls and yet letting your spirit be free, thinking beyond the stage, thinking beyond the old ideologies, the old methods of doing things, the old methods of staying connected. Today we are totally in for a change, and I think we've been doing this really wonderfully. So I think paradox is also one of the things that we are doing for this lockdown. So here it is, totally ideated by Bhavini Mishra to put together this contrast of emotions we are feeling these days into a live performance. You know, the only difference being, instead of being confined to the four walls of those dedicated spaces of, the amphitheaters, the stadiums, today we are in the four walls of our homes. We are physically much connected. I think the word social distancing really does not have any relevance. We are talking to our friends. We can give them a checkup call. We can just connect with them at any point in time. So isn't it amazing? I personally feel it's really amazing to be, you know, so very well connected in a pandemic situation. So today we have five performing artists from totally different studies. Bhavini and Imanshu are dancers. We already know them. And we have Upamanyu Bhanur. He's composed the whole original track for this live stream. I should call it a live concert, actually. You are actually witnessing a live concert in the comfort of your homes. And then we have Adarsh. He will be singing live. And Vicky Bhartia will be making a canvas art. So, you know, with all the emotions and everything that he's feeling with the performance, he's probably going to make something coherent, which works for us. So, you know, although we have gone digital, the thing behind the stage has not really gone digital. We also have Manu Saxena, who's really the cinematographer of the whole of this whole event. It's like a proper event. They were proper rehearsals, and these guys really tried to coordinate, you know, different genres coming together. And Manu has been the backbone. He's been the person who has been able to culminate all this together. Did you just notice that glitch on my TV screen? So, you know, we are totally here, you know, depending on the internet. And please excuse us if something goes wrong. It's a live thing. Things could go wrong. So we want you to bear with us and enjoy this show. Plus, I want to introduce Friends of Art. Friends of Art is a NGO, almost, 8 years old. They started, I think, in 2012. And what they do is they have created a platform for a lot of artists to collaborate and, you know, create some madness for the audience. So let's celebrate this evolution of art and enjoy the paradox. Over to you.
Thank you. तुझसे पूछे इधर कहाँ है। मुझसे आके दस तक पूछे इधर कहाँ है।
Isolation. It can be a taboo for some, and for others, it can be a quest. But today, that's the only option we have, to stay isolated, away. And in these dark times, what is our option? To give up and sit on our knees? Or to be the light, to burn, to ignite our souls, our dreams, our passion, and to rewrite everything that we have known, to look for a new truth, to be the change which this earth, which this world deserves. And to trust and believe in this universe and cosmos to show us a new path. Tu na jaane aas paas hai khuda.
the uncertainty and the conflict of life has always been something that has made us think over and over again, ki ab kya? What next? What is life? This constant cycle of change, change being the only constant. Vision. This word has always made me think. It's made me think again and again. Vision. Vision is something when a human being sees when everybody says it's impossible. For example, maybe I saw a dream of starting a business. Somebody saw a dream of being an artist. Somebody saw a dream of being on television. Somebody saw a dream of just having a small house. Vision has always been the driving force for humankind. Technology, scientific development, everything has come from vision, which turned into mission. And then we did it because we wanted somebody else to benefit from it. But today the question is, in our homes, as we are stuck in this lockdown, how many of us are really asking ourselves this question? Ki ek baar hamara normal wapas aa jaye, kya wo aayega? I mean, I don't know. Jo cheeze pehle normal thi, kya wo ab normal hai? I don't know. Kya wo hongi? Wo aasani se kahin jana, doston ke saath mil jul ke rehna. Is that going to happen in the near future? I don't know. But what I do know is that every single moment, I have a choice. But still, even though I know all the rules, be undefeated, let's be grateful, have faith, this will pass, this too shall pass. Still, I miss the road trip, I miss the ability to just step out. Har insaan is point pe safar kar raha hai. Everybody is going through so much. Some people don't even have money for their basic wages, for their basic sustenance. So right from the time that I've grown up, do now, lockdown or no lockdown, the question for me has always been, what can I do? How can I bring change? How can I be a positive influence? But that answer can only be found in my human spirit. Jab tak main khud ko nahi janungi, how can I help anybody in the world? I need to know my answers. I need to know my path. Not just because of this lockdown, but throughout my life. So I want to use this experience to really go back inside myself again to ask, what is my dream? What is my vision? What is my mission? And how can I continue to bring change?
आसान नहीं है मगर जाना नहीं अब उधर आसान नहीं है मगर जाना नहीं अब उधर मालूम है जहां दर्द है वहां फिर भी क्यों जाए वही कश्मकश वही उलझन वही टीस क्यों लाए बेहतर तो ये होता हम मिले ही ना होते मगर जाने दे आदतन तो सोचेंगे होता यूं तो क्या होता मगर जाने दे वो जो था ख्वाब सा क्या कहे के जाने ये जो है कम से कम ये रहे के जाने दे वो जो था ख्वाब सा क्या कहें के जाने दे ये जो है कम से कम ये रहे के बहती हुई धुन ये इशारे दे कुछ मेरे रास्ते रे सोई सब पल बेकार सपने जागते सोते क्या हो गए हम कहां रंगों साए जहां हो गए हम कहां रंगों साए
Hope. This word has constantly been a driving force for artists, for people, for anybody who pushes themselves to the farthest limits. But at this point, even the strongest warrior seems to be confused. What is the battle really? Where are we headed? What is, what was, what is going to be? Where is the path? And it doesn't even matter who we are. It's just that this conflict seems to rage within me. It torments me. And even though I've been undefeated so often, and even though I have never really given up, at this point, I really don't know what choices to make. What is it that I need to think about? Where is it that I need to focus on?
Krishna, Shri Krishna once said, Mujhme hai Brahman. And I think it's the right time for us to find the Krishna within us, to find that universe within us, to connect with ourselves. And that's how we will connect with everyone else. It's an opportunity to take our deepest fears, our pain, our isolation, and turn it into something beautiful. I remember someone beautiful once said, take your broken heart and turn it into art.
Wow. Take your broken heart and turn it into art. As Dr. Daisaku Ikeda says, hope is a flame that we nurture within our hearts. Hope is that one weapon that we can actually use to fight the strongest, the fiercest, and the most demonic battles. And at this point, the only thing that I think I want to hold on to is the inner spirit that says, no matter what, we can still soar. And no matter what, this too shall pass to open a whole new world of possibility.
Bravo. Well said.
Is everything. Once Buddha said, what you think is what you become. जो आप सोचते हो वो ही आप बनते हो. तो आओ इस पल को जीते हुए अपने दिलों में एक नई उम्मीद, अपने दिलों में एक नया भरोसा और अपने दिलों में एक नया जुनून भर लें और इस चीज को अपने दिलों में बसा लें और इस चीज पर यकीन कर लें कि एक दिन हम इस सारी मुश्किल घड़ियों से निकलकर फिर जी उठेंगे, फिर से उड़ेंगे, फिर से अपनों से मिलेंगे, अपनों को देखेंगे और अपने सपनों को जिएंगे. तो आओ इस पल को फिर से जिए. Thank you.
down together. So, you know, understanding a little more inspiration for people as to how things work during the lockdown, and creating better experiences for them sitting at home. So my first question, this is the first time, I was a part of the show. I did not attend a single rehearsal, and I watched the whole show live. You know, it is a big achievement for me. I have never done this. Usually I'm in the control room, or I'm somewhere fetching somebody, or I'm doing something or the other, and it's always a mess behind the stage. People cannot imagine what they see on the stage and what goes on behind it. It's a totally different show, actually, that's going on behind the stage. So for the first time, people behind the stage and people on the stage are together, and we watched the show together, we did it together, and now we can talk about it without getting tired. For the first time, usually I'm burning out. So my first question is for Umanyu. Umanyu, you made this whole composition just for this live stream, and what was your process, and how did it make you feel to do this thing live, and also what is the difference you did it live online?
It was something very new. Can you hear me now? Can you hear me? Am I audible? Hello? Am I audible? Stuti, am I audible? Yeah. So there's a huge difference.
Can't hear you.
In this particular production and the way we do the production otherwise. So this was on understanding the concept and even watching them performing online on the small screen. So there's a difference, when I go to a studio and I see someone performing live in front of me, there's a different vibe altogether, different energy altogether, which I take it with me, and then I go to my studio and I use that energy to really compose and produce it. But this time, and just watching someone, it was tough on that level. Having said that, technology is actually great these days, and we are trying to still improve ourselves. And playing live and triggering live samples online, there's a latency of few milliseconds. All these things were going back and mind in this process, and the concept, I really loved it. It's a getting to the end results, whether it will be nice, will be good or not. It is the process, it is the journey which matters to me a lot. So I enjoyed it, and we did a lot of rehearsals, online rehearsals, which was very new to me. Internet was dropping, and so many other technical glitches were happening, but. I enjoyed some part of it. Some part was video and, discuss the whole thing. So it's a mixed feeling altogether as far as this production is concerned.
So, Panyu, I cannot hear quite a lot of things, so what to say. But, yeah, now I can hear you properly. So what was the, can you just repeat one of your key experiences with the process of doing this online?
There are many. I'll share some of it. The technical part of it, one part was brilliant. You can be in the studio and you can collaborate with different artists. was you couldn't feel the vibe of the concept of call it. You know, when you feel someone, when you meet someone, you know, face to face, you feel the vibe of it. So that was missing. Show shot, that was missing. And the other part of, say, technology, easily sitting in the room, not working, you can, you know, work till late, and all those things were quite comfortable. We had a long jam. Me with a lot of latency and on internet dropping and all. I miss so,
So I feel that online jams are really better than traffic jams. So thank you. And I hope people get more inspired by, you know, listening to you guys and so I'll move to Bhavini. She's the ideator of the show. She's the whole flow of the show and, you know, created the whole concept around it. So I have a small question for her that, you know, just sitting at home, what triggered this emotion in you and you wanted to go live with so many artists and what really triggered that concept to do it live with all the people?
My inspiration actually came from Shoini. You know, she's the director of Friends of Art and Friends of Art. And what this idea of putting things together was basically to instill hope in people. You know, that, of course, for many artists who are so used to performing on stage on a regular level, you know, for us, in fact, even our entire day goes by in the studio with our team members, with our artists, with our, you know, so that hasn't happened in a very long time. And a lot of people are struggling so much. There's so many artists who are absolutely clueless about what's going to happen next, you know, and they're trying to find ways, online classes, et cetera, et cetera. So when Shoini suggested this idea, and she told me and she said, and she was very kind to give me this opportunity to, you know, sort of think about the theme as to what is it that I want. The first thought that came to my mind was paradox, because, and as she beautifully put it, you know, I remember when we were discussing it, she said, yeah, you know, confined physicality and unlimited spirituality. So, I mean, that is really the way that paradox came about, actually, through our discussions. Because this is what we are facing right now. We're locked in four walls. But our being artists, our minds are like these, you know, falcons and phoenixes and these eagles. They want to soar. They want to, I mean, our ideas are just unlimited. We want to do so much, but then we have restrictions. So, how do we work around that? I mean, this new necessity is the mother of invention. To stay locked in is actually creating a pathway for all of us. So I think that's where it comes from. That's where that's actually manifested paradox.
That's so true. And also, you know, like the thing is, earlier, like when we were performing in auditoriums and every other physical space, we had a limit of people who could attend. Like our reach was very limited. Even if we put it on YouTube later on, it's nothing like what happened live. Obviously, there is a lot of media that goes away from the live performance. So what really happens in a live thing is that you really interact with the person and you're open to interpretation that there and then. Because when you see something edited, you are actually looking at the artist's perspective.
So when right now, for example, when we were doing it, it was, I mean, we knew that we were at the risk of a lot of things. We were at the risk of an internet glitch. We were at the risk of, you know, we knew that this is happening live. We can't run out of breath because we know we have to come back for a talk, and you know, we can't really. And then we wanted to be being artists who are crazy. We were ambitious enough to do, you know, we brought in property and we brought in, like, Himanshu came up with the idea of lights, and you know, it was just like, I mean, we just didn't want to play it simple. You know, it wasn't just a simple dance. It was a lot of
They were like, the elements were endless. Like, I could see so many things happening.
Yeah, and you know, the biggest fear of an online is that what if somebody's internet goes off, you know? What if there's a power failure? What if there's a... So that we put all of that aside, and I think our rehearsals and our effort kind of led to this, that we didn't have really those many glitches, maybe some here and there. But like, by the end of it, I am feeling a little satisfied. But of course, as an artist, what I miss is that, I mean, who can replace the sound of applause, you know? There is absolutely nothing in the world that can... I mean, I remember as a 15-year-old, the first time I got on stage, and I was blown at the sound of, you know, the thunderous applause that we got for a very small little thing we did. And, you know, so I mean, in an online thing, so many times during online classes also, you know that the students are writing to you, but you can't see them. You can't feel that energy. So, of course, you're by yourself. So, of course, it's very... There is absolutely no comparison, actually, you know, because there is a bit of that which we played in this as artists. And then there's a bit of this. Actually, I don't know if we can ever play a bit of this in... preparation. Preparation is what is similar in both. We didn't take it for granted. Anytime we put up a performance, we don't take it for granted. It's an important experience we share with people who watch us. So I think for us, it was pretty much that. And we were aware that we have an online audience, and we wanted to give the online audience something different than just, you know, something. I mean, we're always putting up dance videos on Instagram, but to weave this together was very new for all of us.
Yeah, correct. It is something which is different also at the same time.
Yeah.
So thank you for that. And Himanshu, I have a very interesting question for you. So I want you to tell me what is your take on, you know, live offline and live online. Which is better? What are the pros and cons? And and you really think the difference matters? Like, eventually, we were already, even before this lockdown, we were in an age where we were already digitally very savvy. We were already looking at people, from every aspect of art. I was attending the, you know, world's most famous calligrapher's class, learning from him. So for me, it became a boom. But what about dance? Like, what do you think it's going to be for dance for a few months, I guess?
First of all, Stuti, I had a very different idea of it before we started. But now when the show is over, I feel a little difference. Like, the feeling that you have after the show is over, the curtain is down, and you go backstage. My bedroom for the first time, and it took me like 5 minutes.
Yeah.
I finished my performance outside. I sat there for 5 minutes. I came back and I sat in my bedroom, and it has never happened like this. Yeah. There were no claps. Yeah, there were no claps. I couldn't hear any. The new claps were ta-ding, ta-ding, the number of texts coming in from all over, people sending big comments. Okay.
Still getting the texts.
Yeah. And that, some people are like always telling me, what were you doing? Some people are like, wow, this was beautiful. Yeah. My parents are sending sabatakura. It was interesting. It was a new restriction. You know, stage right. is so planned. You know, you're comfortable out there. You've done your tech run, and here, even after you've done your tech run, you're on the mercy of internet.
Yeah.
Whether it'll shine the light on you today or not, you don't know that.
But it's the same offline as well. You know, glitches can happen on a stage at a larger scale. You know, sometimes they're the worst glitches to ever happen. Like, you know, somebody could get injured, somebody could not be accessed. And the walkie-talkies, all of you are totally experienced with walkie-talkies. How to reach people, it becomes a thing.
It's good. You know, that was a good part. This time I didn't have to run and check on others. For a change, I had a show where I had to not check on anyone. This was a good part of this show.
I was just
in my own space, and spacing was the easiest part for this show. There was zero distraction. And I think the biggest credit here goes to Manu, the guy behind the whole technicals of this. He made you so comfortable. He was like, oh, you don't have good internet, I'll send you routers. Oh, you need something else, you need some booster. I don't know what things he was talking about. Actually, my internet was...
Yeah, cheers to Manu, really.
Yeah,
amazing.
Cheers to Manu. He was very helpful. He would always keep up. If something goes off, I mean, it looks like, oh, they're just performing. But trust me, when Manu was designing everything for us, he was going crazy because everything is gone and everything had to be restarted again. So it was crazy experience, I would say, when it comes to technology. I never knew something like this is possible or people are even thinking about it. I mean, I was planning a different thing altogether when lockdown started and there were new ideas coming in. But internet, using internet in this way, wow. I mean, Shohini and Manu, bravo. And then Bhavi came up with this concept.
Bravo.
So I think... And again, my biggest challenge was, can music be heard on an online performance so well? And Manu was bang on it. I mean, Upamanyu's music is so powerful. But every time I hear it on live music, it's not so good. But the way Manu does it, using technology, using I don't know what all instruments and what all softwares, when music goes through all channels and then he gives the out. It's brilliant.
Yeah.
He's done it so amazingly. Like, it actually looked like a cinematographed composition. Like, I could see the interactions happening with totally digital. And I know the UDC studio. So I could imagine, like, how things are happening over there. But, you know, the spaces I did not see, like your studio. Like, I don't know where Vicky was doing his canvas. I don't singing. You know, you get that power of imagination to just explore that, you know, what else. And I think as and when this technology will evolve, we will all be more interactive with it. We will all be more conscious of how we can make it better. Because the same, learn proper stage lighting just to be able to photograph things. So, you know, designing for stage, then you have to know the lights, you need to know photographs, you need to know how video will work. You also need to know how sound and light coordinate. You know, that is such an important thing. So
I'll show you something, Stuti. Wait. These are my lights, huh?
Mm-hmm.
There is a crystal turtle hanging in the middle.
Yeah.
And this is a lamp which I've put upside down, which is supposed to be a rock salt lamp. Then I have a torch here. And then that's how the lights were. And I think that's another beautiful part of this performance was that you were pushed to go beyond conventional ways of doing things.
Yeah,
you were supposed to think out of the box. Things that you were all, oh, I need these lights. Oh, no, you don't really. That way, I think it was just brilliant. Minds were opening as every new option. Like, I was like, we start like this. Now, what do I do in the second part? No, the frame, I don't know how will it look. Okay, let me change this light here. Okay, let me put this here. Let me change my clothes. Oh, change of clothes was the easiest part ever. Oh my God, on stage, it's always such a panic. Like, I have an anxiety attack in between my costume changes. And today,
you don't even have to change. Go behind the stage. You just have to go behind the camera.
Yeah. I mean, I didn't even have to do that. Manu would take care of that. He would just... change the frame. You change your costume. Be where you are. It's like changing on stage without any care. So that way is it. See, I don't know what are pros and cons in this whole scenario, but I think this is the way it should be. We should not stop. We should continue our journey. We should push. We should thrive for more. And we should take everything as an opportunity. And this is a good example of us taking it as an opportunity. Going
Absolutely.
Out there and not really caring about or to be honest, audience, not caring about anything else, but showing what we feel inside us and just putting it out there in the universe. And that's all we did, I think, today.
Yeah.
That way, and I feel great about today. I feel, is there a difference? Yeah, it's a big difference between stage and online performance. But I think that should be, there should be a difference. Yeah. It should not be same. It's like happiness. Happiness can be of different sorts. So this was a different sort of happiness. And I thoroughly enjoyed it. And I would really love to thank everyone. Manu, Upamanyu, wow, Upamanyu, what music. Then Bhavni, oh my God. This woman kept going crazy on what should happen where. Oh, what should I put there? Oh, wait, let me make another diagram. Lord, let me make another schedule. Oh, this minute's this. No, this beat has to be this. That was crazy. For me, it was the most chilling part because I was supposed to just dance for a change. I wasn't directing anything. I wasn't choreographing anything. I was just sitting and saying, mujhe kya karna hai? Okay, this time, cool. That's all. So I think I had a gala time where everyone else was going crazy. I had a real gala time again.
And also, I think our synergy, our vibes were very synced, you know. I mean, that really, I think at the end of the day, it really, a good performance, whether on stage or online, it all comes down to the people who are actually representing it and how they kind of work together. The patience level, the happiness level, the joy level, the ability to put sleep aside and do this through the night, you know, and then the ability to practice it, to get onto the WhatsApp call, connect and figure out and plan the flow, be aware, be open. So many things. I mean, there's an endless list of thank yous that we can pour out for this very, very wholesome experience we had. I, for me personally, I think this was the best experiences and gave me the, you know, it just gave me that pump again to, you know, that, yeah, you know, there's no restriction really, as Himanshu said. So there is no limitation. It's just it's in our hearts. And yeah, that's.
So thank you, everybody. And, you know, I really loved today's live, and especially, you know, the whole process of being inspired by these people to, you know, continue making art despite of whatever challenges you have. Art really has no boundaries. Like, you don't have to limit yourself to any damn thing. You don't have to think that, you know, I am, you know, these days the Instagram is such a crazy thing. People go crazy. Why am I not getting likes? They're boosting posts. They're putting in money. You really don't have to care. You know, one person who really appreciates your art, that's it. You don't really have to, you know, think about it too much. Secondly, you know, being online has to 24/7 in all the countries all over the world. It's a pandemic. Okay. And we are already pan-connected. Let's not forget that. Now we have the internet, you know, just imagine those times when people were suffering from plague and they could not. You don't have anything to be anxious about, to be upset about. Yes, I know we are all facing challenges, but on this note, I would request everybody to, you know, just follow an art. And if you guys still don't have a hobby, make one, do something. And I run a blog by the name of Art Experiences, so in which these days I'm taking everybody through a journey of calligraphy. So, you know, I'm just going through the whole process from, you know, just developing patience to a level where it becomes a meditative art. You know, same when I was learning dance from Bhavini, I understood, you know, certain things that when you work on your body responds to you, it answers you in so many. Really feel spiritually enriched also with arts. You know, it comes with every art form. I have experienced almost like 12 art forms by now, including photography, including, you know, a zillion other things. And I still like to be backstage just because I don't care about the likes. So it's just, you know, just to give you a little boost, do present your work, do get out there, do show it, and don't worry. The time will come for the right thing.
I just feel like now that you're gonna wind the party. I wish we all were together.
We should just do a virtual, like, we should get back on a call after this. And then,
yeah, I'm going to look for my corkscrew. Let's party after this.
Yeah, and I'm going to, like, poke the water.
I'm totally dressed up for that.
I do want to sort of again thank Upmanyu for the beautiful music that you design. And Upmanyu, you say that you just said in right now that you missed, you know, experiencing the vibe, you know, but I could see what you were going through in the rehearsals, you know, when Himanshu and I were doing it, and I could see with how we were, you know, kind of trying to approach the music in our own way in the limited time capacity, because there's so much more that we could have done and so much more that we both wanted to do. But thank you so much for giving us this beautiful music. And Stuti, thank you for the creatives, you know, the poster work and the artwork that you did for us for Paradox. I mean, it was absolutely amazing. It's eye-catchy. Everyone who saw the poster said that, oh, this is really strong. It's really eye-catchy. You know, this, it just, you brought out the essence of that in the creatives. And of course, Vicky is not here. So I think we really should, like, you know, kind of applaud for Vicky and for Adarsh, because they really kind of, you know, did absolutely this for the first time. And Vicky did this outside his room door. You know, it was his room door that he did this on, and it took him a lot of space, and he's a mover, so he wanted to do a lot more, but what he came up with was so beautiful. And he also understood the theme, and then he said, okay, why don't I bring two figures when I explained him. So beautiful work, and lovely by everyone. Yeah, it was so amazing. I would have missed the rehearsals, actually. Yeah.
You guys better prepare for the next show. It's time to wrap up, so we can't keep doing this discussion, although all four of us can do an after party after this. So just a reminder, next Sunday we are live again with Friends of Art. Do watch the new performance. I will soon get the theme, and I think you part of it. So it's gonna just do watch it and celebrate art.
Bye-bye. Cheers. Ciao. Bye-bye.
Bye.